So just to do a quick recap, first watch just went by and nothing was heard or seen, and the second watch has now begun.
So exciting!
Alright.
And nothing was heard or seen.
That is the best introduction ever. It explains nothing.
Also, we now have a hippogriff in the party.
Yeah.
Say hello.
Okay, I'll explain the hippogriff.
My horse magically grew wings.
During the night, Karkalor's companion came to him. It had been away for a while due to it feeling ill. It is now caught up and is well rested and able to join the party.
Yay, hippogriff.
Alright.
Minutes?
Swag.
So a few minutes go by, and still nothing's happening, but you hear some more rustling. And some odd sounds coming from the area around you. And you see faint glows coming from the path you came from.
Like light flame glows, or?
Yeah, flame glows.
Well, it'd be ready, crossbow.
Alright, alright.
And keep an eye on them. And possibly I'll wait until a little bit longer to start signaling people.
The flame seems to stop and they just stay still for a while. Can you do a listen for me?
Yes, I can.
Alright, give me a second, I just have to roll. Because I've forgotten what it was. Jesus Christ. I've got a rim right in front of me, but I'm just lying, apparently.
That's a good listen check.
Okay. So.
Gotta wait for them crackers.
Wrong crackers. Oh! You hear some sounds coming from the opposite side of the building you are on.
Oh, God. Right, draw another crossbow, head to the middle. So I can get a good glimpse, a good view out of both sides, and have a crossbow pointing at each one.
All right.
Fucking.
Too many crossbows.
What about your third crossbow?
Don't need that yet. To be fair, anyone can use two crossbows; they just can't reload it.
Yeah, you can, but it was like take.
You take reduced
ages.
Yeah, I do. It negates me from something like plus 12 to plus 8.
Yeah. As a ranger, you get some pretty nice bonuses for it. Alright. Slowly entering your vision are... if I can find my tokens.
More kobold. Oh, they're not kobolds at all.
Some small dog-like creatures are approaching the encampment. They seem to have a fiery aura around them.
Oh, fuck, hellhounds.
Precisely. Does your character know that?
Possibly.
Mr. Wiggles is scared. There's danger ahead.
Mr. Wiggles does not know.
Should I roll, like, knowledge something?
If you want, yeah, you can roll knowledge. I'd say it'll be knowledge... just a general knowledge check. I'll pull it in from different bits and bobs.
What is my...
Because it's not really natural hellhounds. I wouldn't say they're natural.
They totally are.
What is my intelligence?
I used to play with them like every day in the mornings. So, like, hellhounds are totally natural.
It's a grumble.
Yeah, I know fuck all about them. Oh god, fiery dogs.
Fiery dogs.
Which point it'll be... Gentle kick to Humphrey to try and wake him up. He's the closest to me, and tell him to get everyone ready.
Oh, Lord William, stop beating me.
It is not William.
Oh god, it's happening again.
At this point, he would wake up, see, I assume, the big glowy dogs.
Actually, the tent would block his view.
He not see the other ones.
Oh yeah, he should be able to see the other ones, actually.
At which point, he will worriedly shake my Lord William's tent, crying like a little bitch. And he will then scoot Barbie girl into here to hide out the rest of the fight.
Scoot Barbie girl.
Alright.
Yes.
Roll initiative. Except for those who are asleep.
God damn it. God damn it, Humphrey, I told you to wake everyone up.
Oh, he's crying like loud. I'd be surprised if anyone
Everyone roll listen. See if you wake up.
How do I roll this one? I don't even know.
1d20 plus.
Oh, I have super sensitive bat hearing. I actually do. My die bag gives me +2 to listen checks.
Those who did are going to act. Those who fail are going to act surprised. Doesn't look like anyone's going to fail. It's just depressing. I don't know why Luke is. You're
no, that's my initiative. What? That's my initiative.
Oh, your initiative. Okay.
Alright, my bat has +12 to listen, so let's see if he wakes up.
Oh yeah, I'm going last. Plus dex.
Kipo is nestled in a nice little boulder, he's not waking up.
Yeah, alright, my bat got nat 20 plus 12. So you know, I think your bat's awake.
Awake.
All your bat can hear is Humphrey crying in the corner.
Alright, so...
I got a 28. So I'm pretty sure I'm
awake. Everyone but Kippo and Ezreela have awoken due to this crying Humphrey.
Yay, heavy sleeper.
And they... those who act surprised, they do not get to join in the first round.
Oh.
So everyone else, initiative?
I did, I got 5.
Alright, 5.
I got, what was it, 19 for my initiative.
Alright.
Initiative is plus dex, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah.
So my bat gets...
5 there.
5.
So Kyram got 15.
Got plus 5? Yeah. Alright, my bat got 21. I suppose it'd go when I go. What's my plus 22?
Yeah, it's just going to go when you go, so...
Yeah, what's
do what you got?
Oh, okay, so take away 4 from that.
Alright, so 17.
I got 17.
Alright, let me just roll up for my little doggies. And cute little doggies!
They're going to die.
Oh, don't be mean to my cute little doggies.
Handle animal, go.
Oh, well, I've got my... Oh, no, I have to do my spells when I wake up, don't I? Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, wow, I've got a natural 20.
Oh, God, initiative 77.
Yeah, that's all of their separate. So we'll have you as the one who got 22. You can have... You can have 14. I regret making so many.
Yeah. It's alright, they're not very tough.
Right.
As a question.
Yes.
Are they small creatures or are they medium?
They are medium.
Ah, fuck. Because gust of wind would completely fuck them up if they were small.
Glenn, how long was the first watch?
That was a couple hours, I'd say.
Actually, I assume we're doing 3 hours each watch.
Maybe sure there's three watches, then yes.
I'm pretty sure that's what we agreed.
So would my spells have recharged for the day?
I would say half of them would. You have half your spells.
Well, I didn't use half my spells.
Yeah, so you only got half of what you lost back.
Okay.
Whoops. Oh, that's supposed to be 12. Okay. Okay. And John Torch was 15, wasn't it?
Yeah, 15.
Oh wow, such a long turn order.
Glenn, you said these things are fire-based creatures, right?
They are.
Can I just talk to them and be like, fuck off?
They probably won't listen to you. You can drive.
Well, I can speak fire-based creatures.
And you can roll to like...
Command them.
Command them, yeah.
Yeah, you can rebuke them.
You got things like handle animal.
No, it's because he's a fire cleric, so he can rebuke them as an evil cleric rebukes the undead.
Ah.
He can rebuke or heal fire creatures.
Which is pretty metal.
It is pretty fucking metal.
There we go, we have all our creatures. So first up is our lovely fellow over here, and he is going to run in, because he has a speed of 40 feet, Jesus Christ.
Don't, what do you expect?
He's going to run straight for you, since you're closest.
Leroy Jenkins.
He's going to take a bite at you. He's going to bite. And,
oh god, there's actually 7 of them now.
There should be 6.
There's six of them and the big. Oh, yeah, there's seven. What?
Yeah. What? What are you talking about?
There's one in front of me.
Four, five, six, seven.
There's someone in front. Wait, what? Why is there an extra one?
There's like number
one
seven.
Underneath one.
Oh god. I'm sneaky. Even the GM didn't see him.
Jesus Christ.
Jeepers.
Okay, okay.
How many are there?
The extra one has disappeared, so. Yeah, okay. This is the guy who got 22.
Is he attacking me?
He is attacking you.
21 AC.
Wait, what's your AC?
21.
Why is your how high is your AC?
I have Dragonhide plate mail. Cost me most of my money, but it's completely legit. In fact, I asked you at the start.
Jesus Christ.
Dragonhide plate mail?
Yeah, it's usable by the Fuck! Just
confirmed.
Bastard.
Oh, it still hits. It still hit.
What's my health? My health is 21 as well.
Alright, so that is... Okay. Oops, I accidentally typed in 1g6.
Bad crit, hold
on. 1g?
Ow.
Oh, don't, I typed g again. You took 16 damage.
Okie dokie.
GG.
Enjoy.
Enjoy that.
I will. I'm all about this life.
Right.
Don't worry, Mr. Wiggles is gonna wreck shit.
The Hellhound bites and claws at you, and it sinks its fangs into your flesh, and you can feel searing hot pain coming from the breath of fire. As well. So enjoy. So next up.
I will.
I think it's one of these guys. Yeah, it's this guy.
If you hover over the thing on the turtle, which it tells you.
He is just going to run into the room. He's not going to be able to attack. He's a bit too far.
Run up to someone.
Nah. If you ran up, you wouldn't be able to do anything. He's run up.
Next is
William, who's in his tent.
William the Astounding is going to poke his little old head out of his little old tent. I'm seeing, realistically speaking, he can see these guys.
Yep.
With my minor illusion spell, I'm going to create an illusion across here of a completely solid wall, complete with spikes and other terrifying things, to ensure that those hellhounds have to run all the way around before they can get in an attack.
Hang a little do not disturb sign on the door or wall.
Pardon?
Hang a do not disturb sign on the wall.
Yeah, that's also hanging off it, yeah. And then William, having protected his allies, will begin settling down to go back to sleep.
But my work is done.
Fuck's sake, William!
Oh. Again, they don't get to roll to disbelieve till they interact with it.
They'll be able to smell something's alright.
How would they smell it? It's only a minor image, it's literally just an image.
Yeah, it's an image, they can't smell it.
Exactly, you can't smell a wall.
Yeah. No, they would normally be able to smell a wall.
Better from the other wall? I mean...
Yeah, because there's also the walls there. I don't see how they would smell a wall.
Because they can't smell from a wall, that's the problem!
But there's all the rest of the wall.
Yeah, they'd be able to smell the rest of the wall, so they'd then assume that it's just part of that smell. You're not going to be able to distinguish one small chunk of wall out of the rest of the walls of a freaking building. It's like standing in a field of horse shit. You're not going to be able to notice that bit of ground in front of you doesn't have it without looking, just by smelling, because there's horse shit around you everywhere else.
I just wanted one of the hellhounds to be free to...
No.
Me.
Oh, but yeah, then Humphrey sticks his head back into his tent and just kind of sits there. Doesn't really not Humphrey, sorry. William just kind of gets back in his tent, snuggles up to his
of a traitor to his team.
That's right. All I've done. My action. I've protected people with a spiky wall.
Next up is John Torch.
Yay! All right.
I'm not. I'm not on the turn order. I should have gone before John Torch.
Wait, yeah. You weren't.
I got 17.
You got deleted apparently for some reason, my apologies.
Yeah, get wrecked, fam.
Accident
deleted.
Pain.
Get deleted after 16 damage.
Alright, so, my turn. I'm going to turn into a brown bear for wild shape.
Alright.
Instantly recovering all lost hit points, because I'm in wild shape.
I don't like this.
And I'm going to... it doesn't provoke an attack of opportunity, and I'm going to attack.
Alright.
For 1d8
using brown
plus...
bear stats.
Or
yeah.
Attack.
It's, plus 11 melee.
Brown bears, man.
So I'm gonna roll that.
I hope you get a critical failure.
It's not an owlbear.
Seriously, this thing is so interesting. Alright, plus 11. 16.
Yes.
Swag, and its damage is 1d8 plus 8.
Slap.
For 9 damage. Whoa, come on! To 9 damage.
Alright.
Oh, yeah, I thought I got defused pretty quickly.
Next up is John Torch.
Mr. Wiggles.
Mr. Wiggles gets his turn.
Who's gonna just whee and attack him?
He can't get over.
I can't, alright.
Because he can't really fly because he's inside.
He's gonna move up right to this corner.
Alright.
He's gonna weeble wobble towards him.
Yeah, and then just attack from here.
Alright, auto attack.
I hate it here. He's got a plus 5 melee, he's not as good.
As a bear? I hope not.
You guys forgot most of the things ever to deal with. You
start dying there.
And here
I go, I should have been a dire bear.
Slightly of a harder.
I got 14 to hit. Do you not hit?
Nope, not hit. Swings and a misses.
Swing and a miss.
So you either need 15 or 16 to hit.
Mm-hmm.
Stop calculating things. Alright, John Torch is up next.
Yay! Alright, can I wake up Crepo? I think it's Crepo.
Kippo.
Kippo, yeah. Sorry. Still trying to learn names, you know?
Right. Just keep at it, you'll find it eventually.
Yeah, I'll get there.
Okay, roll initiative to see where you land on the amazing...
I'll be surprised if he gets higher than me. I'll be so upset.
You wake him up and then he acts before you.
Do you think it was initiative or just roll 20?
Time and act.
Roll initiative.
Rusty dexterity.
Alright.
Yeah. Okay,
welcome,
you guys
to the fire
say. So, who has higher? Who had a higher roll out of two of you?
He did, because I rolled a natural one.
Oh, okay. So, yeah. There we go.
Well.
So, Kippo has woken up and still acts before you. Alright, so that's your turn then.
I'm too busy watching.
I'll give you a move action as well on top of that. You can move somewhere.
Yeah, depending on how he wakes him up, if he just kind of boots him as he walks past.
Just kicks him in the stomach a little bit.
Yeah, he could just yell really loudly to do it.
And yelling is a free action.
Fine, he can have a full action. You guys are so picky.
It's the rules, man. You've got to use every advantage.
Currently, these hellhounds stand a good chance of two-shotting us, so...
Yeah, demon dogs, yo.
They do, but unfortunately, someone just who took 16 damage just healed themselves fully.
I took 11 damage. 10 damage.
No, you took 16.
Well, I'm still fully healed. I'm pretty sure I took 10.
Screw.
No, because there was another roll that didn't activate because I accidentally typed in roll G.
Okay. No, yeah, I fully healed myself because wild chip was broken.
I did like roll.
Also, it lasts 5 hours.
5 hours.
5 hours until I.
Oh my god. All right. So, what are you doing?
I just moved.
Right. Okay.
I'm not gonna be cheap. I'm gonna use an action to actually wake him up, so he definitely gets woken up.
Okay.
I was gonna say because otherwise we'd have to listen to it. Next up is this lovely fellow, who has to now notices a strange wall has appeared and is obstructing his path, forcing him to take a fucking long route.
They're also stupid as fuck. They won't even think like, oh, maybe that shouldn't be there, because they're just like beasts and shit.
Well, I mean, there's totally spells that do just create walls out of nowhere, but they're usually made of fire, so...
Alright, there you go.
I might get that next level one, known, actually.
Next up is one of these guys.
When do I get 4th level spells? Fuck it, it's not until level 7. It's so upsetting.
And next up is this guy.
Mm-hmm.
We've got to get in closer.
They're slowly creeping up on you. And next up is Gippo!
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 I guess...
Don't mind me all sleeping here in chat. It's all good.
I think I'm going to try to... I'll take a shot at the one over here. I'll see how close I'll need to get the... Got my bones to check.
30 feet for point blank.
Yeah. Where are you shooting it?
Looks like I'm going to nudge myself over here real quick and try to take a start shot then. I'm going to shoot at... this one.
This one? You are shooting through another character.
Oh.
So you're taking a penalty.
That was in the way?
Yeah, okay. For Griffin is just barely in the way.
In that case, I'll try to shoot the one that's closing in.
Alright, that's fine.
Oh my god.
Auto attack. Which one is that? 20. Number 20.
I've got 20 of them.
No, it's just... yes, it's 20 of them. Enjoy.
Illusion of Dragon and win.
Yep, that definitely hits.
Woo!
Roll for damage.
Alright.
Oh, I'm missing one of them apparently. Yeah, I'm missing one. All
because
right.
You deleted it.
Oh no, I deleted a different one, but apparently...
I got now the entire turn order's gone.
Oh shit, sorry. There
you go. You do yep. Well, son.
You can go in after Kipper on that.
I have some good initiatives, kind of scary.
Yeah, you did. 6 damage. You fire an arrow, and it clunks straight into its rear hip, causing it to screech in pain.
Aha!
It was a successful hit. Very good job,
finally.
Sir. Alright, and next up is... Ta-da, I close a turn order again because I'm not very clever. Cock-a-lo!
Yeah, just shooting the one that's getting closer to me, and I only have 2 crossbows out.
Alright.
So.
It's gonna funk funk.
Auto attack.
I only have 2 crossbows out.
Ah,
oh,
first one hits.
Would the top one be a crit? If you use a real
I don't know, gun. That's why I was asking.
It should
crit
say
range?
In your weapon, shouldn't it?
I can't remember what the crit range from a crossbow is, so give me a moment.
I suspect it's 20, but I may be incorrect.
Possibly. Yeah, ranged weapons are normally 20.
Crossbow, heavy repeating, 19 to 20, times 2.
Oh, okay.
So, I'll have another go.
See if you hit. No.
Ah, so it hits, though.
It hits.
It hits, just not correct.
It's not correct. No killing my hellhounds in one turn, please.
No promises.
Alright. This port, another crossbow bolt, fires
plus
straight.
Plus 1 for point blank as well, actually.
I don't have point blank, I wasted my stuff on getting multi-weapons.
Yeah, you need money. Another crossbow bolt punctures the side of the hellhound as it screeches in more pain. It's not having a good day, you guys are just being really mean to it.
It's his fault.
He hasn't even done anything to you yet.
What?
I haven't done
his
anything,
but he's trying to
hit
you
in the face.
That's his friend. Now you might not get along well.
That's his friend.
Next up, next up is the guy who got added in towards the end.
Who ate? Oh no! Oh no! No, no, no.
He's just going to move up to here. They're creeping in closer. And da da da! We're back at the beginning. Ezreal, listen, roll to see if you heard any of that combat.
Oh, I can't remember what the thing was. Just,
20 plus your wisdom modifier.
Oh yeah, I don't think I have a wisdom.
Succeeds.
Hey, I'm awake. Sweet.
Yes, you're awake. Initiative.
I can't
see you
right plus dex mod, right?
Yep.
1d20 plus 1. So I actually do this right.
5! We get the highest 5.
Yes!
A lot of
sweet. I am friggin' good at these rolls.
Sorry, that was good as us two.
I got the best five of the lot.
Upon seeing you turn to the bear, he is horrified that he can't back down his situation. He's going to be attacked. He's going to try and, like, fight.
Is he attacking me or Mr. Woodles?
He's going to attack you.
Alright, my arm class is now 15.
Oh, thank God, it's gone down.
Yeah, because I'm a bear now, rather than, you know...
For the Hellhound now fumbles every attack.
Mr. Wheels has an AC of 20. It would be 21, but because he's a large creature, it's only 20.
Oh!
well.
Guys, I'm gonna
Hellhound snarls and snaps at you, but his jaws fail to connect to any part as you slowly just move out of its ray.
Apparently, I'm a soothsayer, not an illusionist.
Next up is this guy. With two crossbows in his bolt, it then leaps at the closest person to attack.
Go home.
Guys, that's
cockle.
Guys, that's the full attack.
Oh, fucking hell. Yeah, that thing is dead.
I like that.
Full attack is tasty.
You're gonna rip it in half, that's insane.
Welp!
Yeah.
GG.
Home, Hellhound.
Another Hellhound just snaps at your feet.
I scared the bear shape. Shit.
Next is William, if he's going to do anything.
Upon hearing like the sounds of further fighting, William's going to stick his head out a little further around his tent. Upon seeing his mantis-y friend being clawed at, he's going to realize none of his spells do any damage. Should I summon Swarm? Well, he's going to try and get a bit of perspective, so I'm going to go, what's 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
You meet a sight of Humphrey crying in a corner.
Put yourself together, Humphrey.
What's up, bro?
What to do? Do the Hellhounds count as on fire?
Yes, I would guess.
Oh dear.
You still have to look away before you do it though.
Oh no!
You guys ready for some fun?
No.
God damn it.
I would actually say they're not valid pyrotechnics targets, personally. But I'll let you decide whether you agree with that or not.
What does it mean to be a pyrotechnic?
It has to be a flame.
Like an open flame?
Yeah, it has to be like a fire.
No, they are not like literally fire. It's like they have fire aspects.
Cigarette off their butt.
Okay, so they'll
probably
could
light a cigarette off their butt, but it would take a while. It also would not be pleasant.
Still have silent.
Really, but you know.
If we create another hilarious illusion. Do I know?
At least the Wirral Hellhounds was like another wall here, so they have to come past the brown bear.
Yeah. Oh man, actually. Oh man, yes.
Follow
okay.
the bear.
They are just going to all attack Sam.
It's gonna follow. They'll follow into Mr. Wiggles and a bear. What are you doing?
What would you do if they actually win this fight?
I would be very surprised. Yep. Okay. So William, being the tactical genius that he is going to make this wall's gonna be different though. It's gonna have a big hellhound painted on it with like a red cross for it. And it's gonna be even spikier though.
I don't think the hellhounds will understand the symbol.
No, yeah, but it's mostly for effect. No, it's about the little details in this line of work.
The little things it was.
Yeah, right. It's like spiky. It looks like it was made by demons. And it just kind of springs up from the ground. That's both my bad illusion spells used up. I've only got one more. But that one's hilarious.
The druid is now going to get attacked by like four of them.
Hey, can tank it, he's a druid. Druids are broken. We took a couple of these that need to go that way.
Maybe two at the most.
Alright, so is that your turn then?
Yeah, I'm just going to keep adding spikes to this wall whilst other people take their turns though.
Alright. Next up.
Does a full attack take an entire turn?
Yes.
It's doing nothing but attacking.
I'm going to do that.
You see?
Okay, are for claws like one attack or are they two separate attacks?
Get two separate claw attacks and then a bite attack.
Alright. Roll for the claws.
Claw number one.
Hit.
Yep.
Claw number two.
Hit.
Yep.
And your
fire.
Bike.
Fire.
And my bike.
Fire.
Does it crit?
No. No, no, there's a crit.
It doesn't crit.
Thank God.
All right. That is plus 16, and then 2d6 plus 4, so that is an...
No, it's 2d8 plus 8.
That's a total of at least...
No, 2d8 plus 16, Sam, because there's two sets of 1d8.
Yeah, so it's 2d8 plus 8 on each side.
Minimum, just so you know, it's a minimum of 24 damage.
Yeah, just to give you a heads up, you killed it.
I want to see how dead it is, though.
Alright.
Just do that. Oh no, yeah, then it would be plus another 8, wouldn't it? Yes, yeah. That's 23 damage.
Just from the claws.
Plus 2d6.
Plus 2d6 plus what was it?
4.
4.
4.
So plus 8.
No, it's just...
Yeah, because you only get the one bite, that's only 14.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's 12. No, that's 12.
Damage.
So you did 23 plus 12, so that's 35 damage.
Yeah.
You've essentially just torn it apart with your claws and ripped it to shreds.
What it looks like.
They're angry.
So my...
They're angry.
The bear's annoying, I don't like it. He has now died.
Hey.
We have slain him.
The bear is annoying, I don't like it, he has now died.
My character's gone, that's it, I'm done.
Enjoy.
You kill the hellhound so hard, you die as well.
Next up, after Sam moves.
Mr. Wiggles. Yep. He's going to move here.
There we go.
And prepare an action. If anyone moves into the one of these two squares, that's his reach. He's just gonna attack.
Fair enough.
So, like, imagine like 5 foot step and takes the rest of a turn to prepare the action.
Alright. Next up is John Torch anyway.
Yay.
So David Cameron, you said.
Yeah, David Cameron.
Squishy bumba.
Yummy.
We really shouldn't look at that because viewers would have no idea.
Alright. Disregard that.
Ignore it.
Oh.
Valid.
You know what, fuck it. I'm just gonna move up and attack. Cause, right. You know, screw it.
Go for it. More to attack.
I'm gonna save the mantis thing.
Mantis thing. I don't think he needs saving. He's weak.
No, it's fair. This thing's just kind of just snapping. And I'm just kind of pushing it away with one foot.
Stop it. That's annoying.
I'm dead, though.
Go. Go away, evil dog thing.
Bad hellhound, bad!
See?
Problem is, if you hit them with a newspaper, the newspaper would catch fire.
And then you have a flaming newspaper to hit them with.
No, I'm pretty full at the moment.
Just shoot him with a wet noodle.
Oh, that hits.
Yay!
Okay, you guys, I'm just going to, like, put you guys against dragons now, enjoy.
Fly away.
Well, that's a bit mean.
Well, stop, like, just single-handedly winning these encounters by such a drastic amount. Jesus Christ.
What are you supposed to do? We're not, like, civilians.
Get wrecked.
What one is that?
11.
11.
Do these things count as an animal or, like, something different?
Hellhounds. They are magical beasts.
Okay, that's... Alright.
So we suffer a negative 4 now.
He's dead. You slam your sword straight down, and it cleaves its neck open.
A tear comes to my eye. It had to be done.
One more fire put out.
Right. So next up is this guy. Which one? This one?
Very top one.
He's going to go for the bat.
That's not where it goes! Oh!
No, never mind. He's going to go over here.
Oh, so he's not going to attack me?
Oh, no, he is! He's going to use a breath attack.
Ooh.
A 10-foot cone. So guess what? He's going to hit both of you. Ooh.
That thing will hit you with a 10-foot cone, man.
How does a breath weapon work? Let's see.
It's a touch attack, I believe. Or it's a reflex save to avoid, even.
It's a reflex save to avoid. So, a reflex save, Sam.
Good thing bears are so dexterous.
They're gristle, motherfuckers. You ever see one ride a bike before?
I've never seen one do ballet before.
Bears have plus 6 reflex, so I'm gonna roll that.
Jesus Christ. Please. No.
Remember, unless you have evasion, you're still taking half damage.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, but some of them, not even that.
Do bears have evasion? No, they have low light vision and scent.
Truly, life is pain.
That's 10 for me. So I doubt that worked. My bat has plus 10 reflex.
Jesus Christ.
But you don't care so much about the bat. Mr. Wiggles will live. I'm pretty sure Mr. Wiggles is not.
Mr. Wiggles still takes damage, yeah.
He's a big creature and he's kind of like shuffled out the way.
No, he shields himself with his wings and flex off the majority of fire. He still takes damage from it. Okay. So let's see how much damage.
Is it? Alright, yeah.
Sam, you take 9, he takes 5.
How much health do brown bears have? 51. So I'm pretty
good. Well.
42 life.
I have a feeling this joke's not gonna get old anytime soon.
And the bat's on 25.
Alright, next up is this guy.
Fucking Druids. So broken.
He's gonna move over to here.
Does that not mean you change size if you're now a bear? It's like you're not small, you're now actually large or something.
Bears are medium creatures.
Yep. Are they?
Yeah.
So he still fits in those rare. Alright,
yeah.
We're doing another breath attack.
Roll bears are actually large.
You too.
Well.
So I'd be taking up a bit more area.
Well.
You say you're standing over the corpse of a goddamn.
Yeah, essentially.
What is my reflex?
Mr. DM, can you enlarge my character model so I'm standing over the other dead body?
Wait, you're large?
Yeah.
Alright.
I don't do fucking minus.
Oh.
Over to one on the left.
Huge. Huge.
That's next there.
Oh my god.
I got 7. Because minus 1. But you can't do minus.
Kakalo successfully reflexed. Dodged it. Well, not dodged.
Reflex save.
Reflex save. Ah, even less damage. Ah, alright. Kaim takes 7 damage, Karkalo takes 4.
Let's go home, you flamey dogs.
Just go home!
It's not like a world
of annoying.
Yeah, don't even worry, just go
home. Jeez. I breathe the fire like glory.
You just accept it.
Dude, I'm only on 38 health anyway, it's all good.
38, Jesus.
Alright, next up is this fellow.
It is. Going
to move here and do a breath attack as well. I'm relying on breath attacks. So
I'll roll my reflex.
And then the DM gets
cheap. The bat's
oh.
Well, Batsy's passed it.
Jesus Christ.
Mr. Wiggy.
I got 16, I don't know if that does or not.
Let me check. It does.
Woo! There is a bat just dodge inside the
side. Wow, so you guys just take 2 damage. Wow.
Yeah, boy.
Wow. So bad.
They can only do that, like, every 2d4 rounds.
Yeah. Stop looking at monster stats.
Plus now,
so that's memory.
The next one can't attack me. Because it's blocked by his brethren.
No, he cannot. Actually, he can. I think.
He
can't. He's one block too far away. Because they can breathe fire for each other, they don't take damage. Next up is Ezreella's turn!
Yay!
Who's finally got on her first turn.
Okay, so let's make sure I measure this out right. 10, 20, so I can move to bar. And then I want to cast Gust of Wind at that fellow.
Alright.
Thank you very much. I can't remember how to do this. It's been a while.
Not much will happen.
Irrelevant!
Oh.
It worked last time, so it should work again, right?
Well, it worked against your party last time.
They got the job done.
Tapped a friend or something. Friendship
beams. I'd have to roll for this. Hey, do I?
Link me for
I like how Humphrey's just like still crying.
Copy and...
Free. No, a rough and tough pasta. Peasant isn't about this life.
He ain't about hair hounds.
Ah, oh, man, they ain't his jam.
A gust of wind. How does this work?
How does it work?
So, it, like, blows stuff around, I think?
You can cast it, but literally, it just means he can't walk towards you.
Yes! Protecting myself.
I'm going to protect myself when I was in no danger at all.
I'm protecting William as well. Don't worry. I am Predator Team.
I'm not sure William accepts help from peasants, though.
Yeah, William probably will slap you.
Peasant, what are you doing? Peasant, right. Stop helping me!
So are you actually going to cast Gust of Wind?
Yes, I am.
Right, there you go. That's your turn.
Yes.
Strong wind is now forcing the already facing away from you, Hellhound, to continue attacking those two.
Yes, I did.
Alright, next up is Kipper. We're under 3-5s, by the way, guys.
I guess I'll sitting there a little shy at that one then. One right in front of me.
Alright, take a shot.
Is that a hitter?
It is a miss.
Luke?
Hello.
You know your illusionary wall?
Yeah.
That doesn't block line of sight from it, does it?
It does block line of sight.
It sucks.
Which is why it's hilarious, if you make a big grey cube covering everything, no one has line of sight, people walk into walls and death traps and stuff. Hashtag illusions.
That's so annoying.
It's so hilarious.
Broken. I've spoken about it before. You walk into a place that has lots of brick walls, and then you make lots of brick walls.
No, you just make it so it's covered in a big grey cube. They can tell it's not real because it's a big grey cube.
No, you create a maze of illusions, and they can't find their way out because there's no exit. So they have to try and walk into walls, and a lot of them are going to be real because of where you've made it.
Oh, Carcolo, it's your turn.
So it would break their mind more than anything.
Don't forget about your animal companion.
Oh, yes. Your griffin has just been sort of sitting outside. It hasn't been able to do something, so it's just watching.
He's just watching it.
Yeah, there's
guy. That's pretty cool. I'm going to take a 5-foot step over here.
Alright.
And then I'm going to shoot that bastard 3 times.
Wow, okay.
Twice even.
That's right. I was going to say 3 times. You didn't have your crossbow, did you? Alright, roll 4 attacks. 16 hits. 15 does not.
Damn. Well, I found the AC.
Oh. Alright, he takes 1 point of damage.
I've got the wrong crossbow out.
where's my good crossbow? Ah!
Try to shoot him with your sword, but oh.
Right. Next up is this.
That's why that shit's not working.
He's just going to growl behind these two.
Menacingly.
Since he can't get to you yet. Alright.
Then it goes straight to William.
Yep, because the other two are dead.
Yep.
Right. What shall we do today?
Don't step in any of these 4 places.
Why?
Because I have plans.
I could vomit a swarm of spiders. That'd be pretty fun.
I don't think, animals are afraid of spiders.
I don't appreciate
no, spiders
you.
Spiders do damage.
I don't appreciate you vomiting spiders behind
that's
me.
That's swarm. Yeah, no, I'm not going to because they attack the nearest thing, so that's probably a bad move.
Yeah.
Jesus
Christ. Oh god, I could make an invisible bear.
Wait, what?
Oh Christ, no, I know what I'm going to do. Alright, with my prepared major image, I'm going to make
another
bear. I'm going to make another bear. Yeah, another bear right there.
Why? That's blocking my position entirely. Don't do that.
Yeah.
Don't do that.
Oh, no, actually, no. No, that's bad. How do I undo?
Erase. You're clicking your delete.
Hang on, let me... what do I do then? I guess I'm just... Alright, so I can only really do one spell and I have to focus on my other spells. I'm going to let the yellow wall fade, so that'll be gone on my next turn, because we don't need it anymore. What have I got prepared today? Yes, I'm just gonna take a shot. I take a 5-foot step here.
Alright.
Put my crossy bow. shoot this one.
Roll for attack.
This is when William is somewhat less impressive and actually comes to killing things.
Rather than fucking up his party as much as the enemies.
That's I actually did pretty well in not...
No, yeah, you helped this time.
This time. Yep, no, never mind, okay.
It's a miss. Your shotgun.
I'm going to blame the peasantish dog beside me for this horrible misfire.
I like this thing, haven't done anything at all.
Just gives you an empty stare and just doesn't say anything.
Is it my go?
It is indeed your go.
I'm gonna take a little 5-foot step.
You encourage... Right, no, you don't.
No, not 5-foot steps, don't. I'm gonna full attack this guy.
Yeah, you can do that, because it's a 5-foot step.
Oh, God!
It's painful.
It begins. Still, it bears are easy.
Alright, yeah. And, does that crit?
I don't know.
No, I believe for most bears it's just a 20.
Yeah,
it would be, because it's a creature, not a... Yeah, it's it would just be.
And then Munchy Munchy.
Munchy Munchy, is that going to hit?
It's plus 6, the Munchy Munchy, isn't it?
Yes.
Is it going to hit?
Yes.
Can you stop rolling so bloody high?
He's not even rolling that high, that's the best part, it's just the mad bonuses.
It's 2d8 plus 16, isn't it?
2d8 plus 16, yep, for the first two. Then I can't remember what the other one was.
Alright, so that's 25 damage. And then it's 2d6 plus 4.
What the knife is that?
That's 34 damage.
He's dead. Yet again, you claw and bite and you tear it bit from bit.
Got rags.
Alright, then Mr. Wiggles is going to 5-foot step to here. He doesn't have a full attack, sadly. So he's going to regular attack the guy in front of him.
Alright.
Welcome to the wall of animals.
Yeah, I've just decided
to die. Off,
guys, like, it will not hurt my friends.
Oh, God. Jesus Christ.
I need to roll a d20 to hit first, plus 5.
This is depressing.
18, is that hit?
The world of GMing, where all your monsters die instantly.
And then it does 6 damage.
What do you think I'm called Cthulhu? They can do anything in that.
For my last action as Mr. Wiggles, he's going to prepare an action that if this guy tries to attack at all, tries to perform an attack action while in my range, I'm going to attack him.
I don't think you can do that.
You can, because all he's done is make a... I'm pretty sure you can prepare a standard action like that. I mean,
he's already taken an action.
Well, he took a 5-foot step, which is a free action, and he's made us. I don't know.
Yeah, but he's done an attack as an action. You have movement, then you have action.
I don't think you can prepare. If you've not used your move, you can prepare a move or something like that.
But I don't think you can prepare an action with a movement.
Yeah, I think you need to. If you've not used your standard, then you can prepare another standard.
All right, then. Mr. Wiggles is going to screech menacingly.
Alright. Are you actually doing an intimidation one?
Fuck it, YOLO. Why not?
Alright, there you go.
I don't know what his intimidation is.
It would be either charisma or strength. Oh. I would say strength based for him.
Yeah, his would be strength based. He gets plus 3 then.
1d20 plus 3.
40.
Alright, what is their...
It's just allowed to. I'm not going to try and do it because that won't work.
Would that be will save?
I'd say, well, it's not really a magical effect, so it's probably like a morale save, so that would go off charisma or will or wisdom, I guess.
Oh, so we'll... Give me a second, I'm trying to find.
Pretty high pitch, though, regardless.
Yeah.
Run out front is fine. Run out back is...
I wouldn't say they run away, they're just kind of shaking a little bit.
Yeah, if the one in the back is shaking a bit, it does not want to get close to the bear.
But the one in front is fine. The bear's fine.
Oh yeah, it's your ally, it's not screeching at you.
Yeah, it does.
Just standing on this poor dead creature.
I think having the dead bodies around is a bit disingenuous, considering they've been like... They're probably spread all over the place at this point. The bear's ripped them into tiny chunks.
Sure as they have.
There's just kibbles and bits everywhere.
The only one that one might live because I only stabbed it.
Yep. All right,
it's not like I ripped a shred.
The other two are just fucking destroyed.
Go on, Torch, go.
Oh, yay. I don't even know what I should do.
Just spat the other one, I guess.
Fuck it. I was gonna like try to command one of them, but it seems pointless at this point of time.
Mm-hmm. So it's all getting eaten by a bloody bear.
Fine, I'll just roll to hit.
Alright, go for it. Hit.
Yay.
What happened to being useless the last battle? You're useless the last battle.
Welcome to all 20.
6 damage, right? You strike at it. Does not seem impressed, but it's still standing. It glares at you as you're its next target.
Fine. You can go for it.
Next up is Hellhound next to the bat. It's going to attack the bat.
Alright. Bat has 20 AC.
Why does it have such high AC?
Because it's an agile bat.
It's got plus 6 in dexterity and plus 5 nat.
That did not hit. Next up.
Alright.
Is this guy. He is going to attack John Torch.
Yay.
Going to bite. Is it successful?
Yeah.
Alright, sweet.
Well, I only have AC of 19.
I don't know that. I don't remember.
Well, yeah, you got
only 19.
Only 19.
Doesn't even reach 20.
What a so camp. Like this bat that has 20.
I absorbed my dragon hide armor when I go into bear form. It actually says that. When I come out of bear form, like a wild shape, it grows back in my body.
You take 11 damage.
Shit, son.
Nom 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 nom.
To the thighs, and you're just like, ooh, tingly.
Yeah, it honestly took 6 points of fire damage.
Well.
He is dead.
Yay.
Next up is Ezreella.
Yay. I was going to do something, but I can't remember what it was.
Carefully.
Hit it with a cone of cold.
Doesn't have any.
Or is that Ray of Frost?
I can't remember. Ray of Frost.
Ray of Frost is the level 0 one. Cone of Cold is incredibly metal and does stupid amounts of damage.
Use Cone of Cold then, that'll be fun.
That's like, I don't even have it yet.
Oh, I think it's like a 4th level spell, it's mad.
Range, okay, so.
You want Fireball anyway, Fireball is the best. Or Flaming
Sphere. Hey, I don't think Fireball is really going to help us here somehow.
Flaming Sphere, go on guys, you can use it.
It's tempting. It really is. Oh, should I not? I don't know. How ridiculous would it be to do inside? It's gonna be a bad idea. It's gonna be a really bad idea.
I have no idea what you're planning.
Oh, it's so freaking tempting.
This is going to be great. Oh wait, oh god no. Bad.
Oh god,
Oh god, giant bear and bat. This is not what I wanted.
I didn't sign up for this shit.
I signed up for easy meat.
Wait,
what have I been linked? A spell?
Yes.
How does it work?
It is tempting.
You could use it.
I could. I know.
It's up to you.
Oh, wait. How far?
Who do you use it on?
I can do that. I can reach that. Sweet.
Oh god, I think I know what's about to happen.
Okay, how do I cast this? Do I have any?
As long as it's a willing person, it's free, pretty much.
Sweet.
Oh, Christ. Well,
as long as John Torch chooses not to resist it.
John Torch, do you want to grow some?
Sure.
Okay.
There's a little girl.
Alright. John Torch begins to glow with a magical aura. He suddenly enlarges in size.
Oh lord. Oh, okay.
So many giants!
Oh, large fat.
Did you enlarge him?
Yep.
Oh god.
Damn. He is my full
of plus 2 to strength, but minus 2 dex. And minus 1.
Fuck it, I have no dex anyway.
But he also gets minus 1 on attack rolls and AC. But you get like plus 1 in attack rolls until because you got plus 2 strength. So it doesn't really matter to you.
That was good.
Alright, is that your turn?
Yeah, that's my turn.
Alright, next up is Kippo. Kippo, what's your reaction to this giant?
Well.
Ain't that some shit?
Wait, how long have I been a giant for?
I have fucking 8
years.
Wonderful.
Can't actually nerf you 1 minute
per level. So 5 minutes.
Hashtag 5 hours.
5 hours of pure bear.
I could come out of it whenever I want.
Why don't you?
Why would
as
you
a standard
want
action, I'm just like, and I'm a druid again. Because I can cast spells as a bear because I took that feat.
Good. Oh, Christ.
But I'm literally just a better character than I was before.
Alright, what are you going to do, Kippo?
Except I can't ride my back.
Okay. Ref, go over here and try to trip him.
To try to trip him?
I don't know, I want to do something.
Tell them to combat.
Alright, how does trip work?
It's a putt. You have to roll to hit.
Alright, roll to hit.
Nothing,
you suddenly have a bard in our group?
It's the hippogriff!
Yeah. Just look over and the hippogriff has got the guitar. The hippogriff has done nothing, so it's just like, fuck it, I'll pull out a guitar.
Sat there, watching us. Gotta make
just,
the
just suddenly saw this human grow.
Just a sad look on its eyes.
Like, love me, please.
Love me!
Senpai, please. Notice.
Alright, that does not hit. Your trip fails. Your trip fails.
Hey, you go wake up a sleeping hippogriff and try and not get bitten.
Alright, so what is Kippo going to do while his dog has sort of just run up and attempted a trip that failed? They just end up barking at each other for a bit while I wait.
I don't like the notion that's actually Kippo running and barking at it.
We're both barking at it. I'll take one more shot at trying to shoot it then.
Alright, take a shot.
Believe
that.
Damn.
Wait a second.
Sorry, could you not? I can't hear Glam.
I can't hear you at all, yeah.
I'm sorry, is that bad? That does not hit.
No.
No, it's because the guitar, I can hear you.
Alright, so that's Kippo's turn over, and we're going to Karkalo, who has now got a giant human standing in his way.
Yo, what's up?
Can't see shit now. Is this wall, like, all the way to the ceiling, or is it?
What wall?
The one behind the two throne-looking
Yeah, things. That's up to the ceiling.
Damn.
Oh, are we, like, still dreamy? Because I'm seeing a lot of weird shit right now.
It's probably going to be just going to move over there so I get a shot at the dog without hitting giant right. Human.
About hitting giant human. That's my meat roll to attack. Up it hits.
Crossbow 1.
No, damn it. Again.
You're doing damage.
I'm still using the nerf crossbow.
Alright. You only using one crossbow, son?
Yeah.
Okay.
I had to move more than
four. I can. So next up is you. He's going to do a bluff attack. He's the last one who can. And he's going to aim at both of you two. You silly people.
Yeah, reflex. So Batsy first?
It doesn't really matter. Oh, it failed!
And me next.
It also failed! Yes! You take the full brunt of the...
And before you roll 2.
10 damage!
So, I'm still okay, folks.
I was Mr. Wiggy.
The bat's on 13, I won't fight.
Alright, he's dead. Zed, William's turn.
Upon seeing some, like, shiggly flames and stuff, I'm getting kinda concerned.
Luke, can you make me look bigger?
I could. But then you don't know that I'm an illusionist, and I can't have that. I could also cast a spell magic on you and make you tiny again, just to be a dick.
Go for it.
DC, the spell magic goes against the spellcaster, doesn't it?
I'm not entirely sure. I'll check. I'm not gonna cast spell magic, but I will check up before I cast it.
Yeah, okay.
There's not much I can do that's useful here.
Can you make us skip Bingo's turn?
I just shoot the thing.
Alright.
I'll cast all the fun spells.
Do you have clear line of sight? Yeah, clear line of sight.
Three. Gonna miss. Oh, snap!
Oh, but we're all again.
Does it crit?
Yep.
It hits.
And well, shiver my timbers.
Oh, well, you're double damage.
In before, I'm gonna roll a 1. Oh, no, that's 8 damage.
Eight damage?
Yep.
Wow. You hit, and he is severely weakened. He's in pain. He's entering. He's full of crossbow bolts at this point.
Oh yeah, he's the one that's been shot loads.
He has been shot though, because I know he keeps shooting him. Poor guy, he's still standing.
And hitting him.
But he's
not. Won't be hitting longer after this.
Alright. Next up. Bingo. This wall has faded as well.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, the yellow wall's faded.
Mr. Wiggles. He's gonna move first.
Alright.
And he's gonna 5-foot step up here. As to not back an attack of opportunity.
Alright.
He's then going to prepare an action for the rest of his go, that if anyone goes in this square, he'll attack them.
Alright, that square?
That square. Because that's his reach.
Alright.
Then my go, I'm going to 5-foot step up to here. And I'm going to full attack the one diagonal to me.
Roll for damage.
Damage, so I'm going to just... Fuck killing, just damage. Alright, first attack. I think that misses.
It does miss.
Second attack. I
hit.
And the
third
attack.
It hits.
Yes.
He won't survive this.
That's one claw and my bite.
Minimum of 19 damage.
He might survive.
It's 1d8 plus 8 is my first attack. So that's 16.
I don't think he's going to survive.
Yep.
And I do 2d6 plus 4. The 10. So that's 26.
Right. You claw and you bite at this one, you crush its head between your jaws, and it goes limp.
Another one bites the dust.
Oh, what's gone.
I love how Sam is pretty much just single-handedly destroyed for encounter.
I'm just
like, while you guys have been fighting too, he's been fighting 4.
Yeah, you had it in your Sam.
Mm-hmm.
But here's a bear.
Right,
he is a bear.
I'm not even half dead.
Giant John Torch. You were.
Stabbed the thing.
I were, and then, you know, bear form.
What even happened to me? I can't remember. I get plus 2 strength, minus 2 dex as well, and then what else?
Minus 1 to hit, but that's negative. Yeah, that's nullified by the fact you get plus 2 strength.
Yep, so you get plus 1 to your attack bonus. You get a bonus attack.
Oh! No, I don't regain full health. I regain a lot of health.
Right. It would have been put you up.
I gained 5 health back, so actually I'm on 11 less than I am right now.
Oh yeah.
So I'm on 19 rather than 30.
Oh, that makes me feel a bit better.
Oh yes, he's suffering, that's good.
He's almost dead.
Yeah, I don't recover full, I recover 1 hit point per level.
Right, so
5.
Let's attack Mr. Torch. Oh, it hits! This might be the end.
You think it's worth trying to keep one of these hellhounds?
Nah.
There's no plus 6, because it's not to hit. Is it only to hit?
It's damage as well.
Oh, okay.
So So you get bonus.
But the penalty is not to damage.
Yeah, penalty is not to damage.
Oh, yeah, so
you get plus two.
You get an extra plus one to damage because you increase strength.
Plus two strength.
Plus two strength.
Oh, is it not just plus two to the stat, plus two modifier?
Oh, yeah, it might be plus one strength then, yeah. Alright.
Okay.
That makes more sense if I think about it like that. So, roll for damage. Alright. The giant John Torch swings his sword down and cleaves the creature in two.
John Torch smash! Imagine it's like. I imagine it's like Darren Volt, but less
flashy.
Spectacular.
Alright, there you go, he's now dead. Next up
is, none of them to go straight to.
Yep,
Ezreal. He's number zero.
Glenn, as a free action, I'm going to stop concentrating to let the red wall fade.
Alright.
What do?
Walk over this horrific battlefield, see a blood-stained bear.
They hurt my bear. Well, they hurt my bear. They hurt my bat. Yes.
I hurt you first.
It's true. And then you hurt my bat.
And then
things got serious.
You turned to the bear after I hit you.
Yes. Okay, so
details.
So I can't see this last hellhound. So
only one who does. It's currently
there's a fucking hellhound. I
you can probably
bear.
Hear like the bear ripping.
Oh yeah, yeah. I actually can't talk, so you just hear. There's various rules of bears.
So I just move over here to listen to the griffin rocking out. Thing was rocking out on its own.
The griffin and it's
no one can see it. But I assume people can't see me.
I think the griffin might be able to see, actually.
People can see me fighting something.
Alright, well, next up is Kippo.
I just hear a bunch of murder going on somewhere else in the building.
Oh,
hey, we'll check it out.
Right. Luke?
Yeah?
Can you do the favor of making me tiny?
Can make it look like you're tiny?
There you go.
Just an illusion of a regular sized torch.
Oh Christ, that'd be terrifying. Like, why is he hitting so goddamn hard?
I'll get us up a rough and try riding. Alright, at least get to a point where I can see what's going on.
Alright. Go for it.
Guess I can at least get this far up.
Yep. You can get rough movement speed up. Huh? Alright, you can see it. You got rough movement speed.
What?
You got Ruff's movement there. So it's pretty much you can move as however far Ruff can normally when you're riding him.
Cool. Can I do anything else? I just try to
shoot
him.
No, you did your action of mounting.
So I'm pretty much done at this point, huh? Unless I can. Okay. Oh, that's one more!
Oh! Okay, what's next up. It's got
him. He's been over here, guys! I don't think he's gonna last. Holy shit, what happened over here?
Just like bits of.
There's. Dogs everywhere!
There's a thoroughly singed bear and bat.
Yeah, I can move there. They were set on fire quite a few times, to be fair.
But, and then I'll be shooting the one that's left.
Alright, roll for attack. Good old zero.
Nope.
Alright, it does not hit.
Go away, nerf crossbow.
Alright.
I knew these foam darts.
It
is horrified and terrified. It's realised that its pack has been decimated. It's still scared of the bat's intimidation.
I roar as loud as I can.
It's going to...
I can't intimidate, because it's not my go.
It's going to run away. And it moves, let's see, 40 times 4, 160 feet. So later.
If I got on my bat, I could catch up with it, but I'm not going to.
You're not
going
to be able to fit on your bat.
Oh, no, yeah, I as a standard action, I can turn off. Into a human again.
Alright, so it's fled.
Yeah, it's gone.
It still counts as a victory, though. You defeated it. It just lives another day.
Yeah.
Can we still hunt it down?
Success.
Well, I assume we're out of initiative now.
Success.
Then can you make me a normal-sized person again?
Are you going to go normal again?
You making a new... I want to be normal size.
Okay, for spell effects wears off, I'd say you've wandered around for a while. Alright, what are you going to do with all these bits of dogs? I wouldn't say
God's sake, Humphrey, you're useless in that fight. And then I'm going to go back to sleep.
Probably chuck them onto the fire or something. Not assuming they're good for eating.
I don't know. Who took damage in that fight?
Me. I took four, so I'm alright. I'll sleep that off later.
I don't actually regain any hit points back, so I'm just on 19. Alright, if you took hit points, come over to me. I'll stand in the middle.
Oh, healing.
I'll go back to
I'm going to use... How many hits did you take, Karen?
Quite a few, actually. I lost 127, and I'm meant to be 45, so I lost quite a lot.
Oh, well, first I'm going to cure minor wounds by bat.
I was about to say, I could just heal myself in the morning, when I actually have spells.
I was going to use all my spells now to heal as much as possible.
Alright.
I don't get any pluses to this, so it's just 1d8 for my bat, innit?
Yep.
So my bat recovers 3 hit points. So it's on 16 out of 20. No. Out of 30.
To be fair, I did a lot of damage with these guys.
Yeah, you did a lot of damage to the bat. Karen, I'll heal you for 2 hit points, because I'll use both my Cure Minor Wounds.
Yay.
Oh, and I'm going to summon berries.
Oh yeah, for berries. I remember the berries.
I have 2 berry spells. Is it 2d4 plus...
I can't remember.
I'll look it up. Gonna just fucking eat berries. Oh, I have to actually have some berries. Shit. Well, I don't have any berries, so I can't summon the berries.
Summon the berries. Release the Kraken berry.
Like berries.
Berries and cream. Berries and cream.
Go ahead.
Alright.
Get back
away. Yeah, I'm gonna go to sleep then and try and heal with up some help.
Alright, so if everyone just wants to roll who's sleeping to see how much health they regenerate if they lost health.
Yeah,
how much do I need to roll
for? I'll say it's a 1d6.
How much XP do we get, by the way?
You get 1,000.